Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the channel once again. Welcome to the delayed flight. Please be attentive because you have to adjust your configurations in the control options, and this is exactly what we will do. We're talking about the keyboard commands. It is good your startup settings to be something like this and not to have all these windows open here. And actually, we'll have a look at the commands of the autopilot. Let me put it like this. If you don't follow these commands or similar commands, I'm afraid that you will not have a bright future in aviation. So you go to search by name, okay, and you type here heading. Here there are four commands that they have changed, and you can follow these steps in order to make your life easier when airborne. Most important is this one, toggle autopilot heading hold. Here you will set this command. The command is Alt plus H, letter H. This command will help you to activate immediately the autopilot heading hold. And also, in order to increase or decrease your heading, you will select these two commands, increase heading bag, CTRL plus insert, and decrease heading bag CTRL plus DEL. In general, with the upper buttons, which are insert, home, and page up, you increase something. We have said those things lots of times. And with the lower keyboard commands, delete, DEL, and page down, you decrease something. So according to the faucet, this will be your new toggle autopilot heading hold, Alt H. And with these two commands, CTRL insert and CTRL del, you increase or decrease your heading. The most tricky command is this one, Shift plus H. And this activates actually the heading mode in the Boeings. It is also needed, but not for the time being. In order to change these commands, you go, for instance, let's say here. I will not show you those things. If you have any questions, please do ask me. You clear here, and then you type the command. For instance, this will be Alt plus H, and then you validate. Next, you type here VS, which is the vertical speed. And you do exactly the same thing. Toggle autopilot vertical speed hold. The command will be Alt plus V. And in order to increase or decrease your vertical speed, the rate of ascent or rate of descent, new commands will be CTRL home for increasing and CTRL plus end for decreasing. As you notice, once again, the three keyboard commands, insert, home, and page up, increase something. And the three lower keyboard commands, del, end, and page down, they decrease something. So exactly as you see, the autopilot vertical speed hold will be activated with Alt plus V, and increase or decrease your autopilot vertical speed will be with CTRL plus home, and decreasing will be CTRL plus end. And then we go to altitude hold. So if we type here altitude, here is the command on the autopilot, which will be Alt plus A in order to activate autopilot altitude hold. This stands under the commands of the autopilot. And these are the two commands in order to increase or decrease your altitude, the altitude that you set on the autopilot. For increasing the altitude is CTRL plus page up, and in order to decrease your altitude will be CTRL plus page down. Once again, insert, home, and page up, increase something. Del, end, and page down, decrease something. Now, in order to activate your autopilot, there are many ways, of course, as you know. I prefer to activate my autopilot from the joystick, actually, but you can as well set here toggle autopilot master. You can as well set letter Z, or you can activate your autopilot from your cockpit pressing the AP button, the autopilot button, which is something that I wouldn't recommend to you. I wouldn't recommend you to do so. There are also other keyboard commands that you must adjust here. but at the time being, we will be focused on these ones. And either if you fly Cessna or if you fly a Boeing, these commands are needed. Okay, so we have the Cessna 172, the plane that it is sold more than any other, and we will practice these things. Okay, I deactivated the autopilot, so we must bring the plane at straight and level flight. Have a look here. We engage the autopilot. Engage your autopilot the way you prefer. Here it is, AP, with green letters. Autopilot is engaged. Then we correct our heading. Somewhere here, about 260, 270 degrees. Please have a look. Alt plus H. Here it is, heading mode. Heading mode is engaged. Then we set the altitude mode on autopilot, which is Alt plus A. Here it is. By the way, if you receive a message about low volts and so on, I don't know, something here with the alternator has to do, so set this to on. So as we see here, pressing Alt H, we activated the heading mode. Oh no. Okay. It is okay. Give me a second, please. I hope I got rid of the ATC. So, straight and level flight. And now, we want to change our altitude. How we change our altitude? We must activate the vertical speed autopilot mode, isn't it? So, have a look here now. Alt plus V. Here it is. Have a look here on the PFD, on the primary flight display. It is set to zero. Decrease are the lower buttons. The command is CTRL plus end. Exactly here. Let's say minus 500 feet per minute. And we decrease our altitude, CTRL plus page down. 900, you see here. 800, 700. So we are waiting to stabilize our plane at 700 feet with a rate of descent, of 500 feet per minute. Have a look here, 700 altitude, 500 feet per minute vertical speed rate of descent. You see, Alt hold is activated here. And we have an altitude of 700 feet exactly. And by the way, this autopilot is quite accurate, the autopilot of the Cessna 172. Now we want to turn. Okay, I can use here the mouse. Heading mode is on, isn't it? Alt H. So let us turn. Always have a look at your speed, by the way. Let us turn to the north. Have a look here. This blue dot here on the compass. Let's go north. You see, we are turning to the north. Let's say close to 360 degrees. I can as well do this with the keyboard commands, but this is not our matter right now. Let us continue descending. Altitude 700. Alt A, new altitude will be 400, and Alt plus V, rate of descent, CTRL plus end, 500 feet per minute. Okay, so as we see, our new altitude is only 400 feet. Our runway, I think, is, which one it is, 11. We turn to the east. Okay, I can use the mouse here. because heading mode continues to be on, isn't it? Here it is, heading mode. And just for practice, I will use the heading mode. In order to more or less line up with runway 11. Let us descend another 100 feet. How we do this? Here is our altitude, 400 feet. CTRL page down. 300 feet here. And Alt V CTRL and end. Again, 500 feet per minute, quickly. Okay. I can as well use the VFR map. Huh, just fine. It looks just fine. I suppose we come from the other direction. And I think runway is runway 11. This plane is quite tricky when it touches down. You must not hurry to apply the brakes. And has a stall speed of about 45 full flaps, I think. Can I go on full flaps? 20, isn't it? You can skid off the runway quite easily. Yes, don't hurry to apply the brakes. Okay. I hope I recorded this time. Let us have a look at this landing. I mean, mostly about the touchdown. Of course, these planes are much more easier to land and to have a, as I used to say, decent rate of descent and touchdown, a decent rate of descent. Okay, we will not insist much. I think it is a touchdown of about 30 feet per minute, which is of course good. I wish life was always that easy as with the smaller planes. I mean, when you land. Let me have a look. But I had to cancel landing lots of times, as I noticed, because I am not used to such height from the cockpit, isn't it? For instance, here I didn't land. Here also I didn't land. Okay, something like 35, 40. I think it is about 35 feet per minute, but I'm not used to at all flying with bigger airliners. Yeah, 2-3 times I didn't touch down. Okay, something about 35-40. Yeah, exactly. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is all for the time being. I just wanted to show you the most basic commands of all, which are the commands, the keyboard commands, in order to activate the altitude on the autopilot, the altitude mode, the heading mode, and the VS mode, the vertical speed, your rate of descent or ascent. And this is combined with CTRL plus, isn't it? It would be either insert, home, and page up. The upper keyboard commands would be in order to increase something, and the lower keyboard commands, del, end, and page down, will be in order to decrease something. Hope this was useful. Don't forget to comment, thumbs up, to subscribe if you found this tutorial helpful. Thank you for watching this clip and hope to see you soon to the next one. Till then, you take care. Bye for now.